All right, we're back with another beginner lesson for Linux, and in this one we're going to show you some basic file management commands for the command line. We're going to go over how to manage files using the cat command, using the nano text editor, using the touch command to create a file, and using mv to move. We'll just be moving, we'll be renaming. We'll be creating and deleting files, and it's gonna be fun. This is all really basic stuff, but this is all very, very important. So thank you for joining me here on Fairly Basic Tech. Let's take a look at the screen and get started. So here we are back in our command line. This is the bash shell on Arch Linux, but if you're on any Linux, it's gonna be this basically. You gotta go out of your way not to use bash, so we're sticking with the commands that work there. If you don't have Linux set up, I recommend taking a look at another video I created about creating a virtual machine with Manjaro. I'll link it above, and you can get started there just to get it installed. And once it's installed, open up a command line, and you can follow along and we'll create and move some files. The first thing I'm going to do is create a directory to play with, and I'm just going to do that with mkdir, and we'll call this test1. And I'm going to create another one, mkdir test2. LL. LL shows everything that's in there. We got test one and test two, and that's where we're going to be playing today. So change into that directory, cd space test one. And of course, if you list whatever's in there's nothing in there. Now the screen's a little bit cluttered. I want to clear it up. There's two ways that you can do that. You can type the word clear and press enter, and that'll do that. The other way to clear the screen is with a keyboard shortcut. Control L does exactly the same thing. I didn't know that for far too long. Control L clears the screen. That's really useful. Control D will exit your terminal session, so that's good to know too. Don't be pressing that when you're not ready for it to exit. Okay, so we've created a directory. Now we want to create a file. To do that, we're going to use the touch command, touch. And we'll say testfile.txt. We will list, and we will see there's a file in there called testfile.txt. It's important that you include the file extension if you need one, or don't if you don't, but you have to create the complete file name for Linux to create the file. Now, we went over the cat command in the last lesson. We run that here, there's nothing in it. What we can do is go to nano. If we say nano space test file, that brings up the text editor, and we can create some stuff to go in the file. And then we can control X to exit, Y to save, enter to write it. Now, I use the up arrow to cycle through my past commands. Cat test file has what we wrote in it. So that's good. We have a file with some text in this test one directory. Now, what if we want to move that file? Say we want to move it into test two. What I can do is say mv, the file name, and then the directory of where we want to move it. In this case, it's home mark test2. We do that. Now if I ls, it's not there. If I cd dot dot slash test2. Now look what I did here. I go cd space dot dot. That moves into the directory above me, which is home slash mark. And then from home slash mark, I go into slash test2. That does exactly the same thing as if I had done cd space slash home slash mark slash test2. That's just a quicker way to get there. And using little shortcuts like that will save you a lot of time. So, CD, now you see I'm in test two. I can do a PWD. I see I'm in home, mark test two. I can do an LS. I see this test file is here. I can do a cat, and I can see that it's the same file as it was before. That's good stuff. Now, what if I want to rename it? In Windows, you would just type rename. That's not an option in Linux. Linux thinks about it a little bit differently. From Linux's perspective, we're not renaming the file, we're moving this file into another file. So basically, we just do what we did before, except instead of moving into a directory, we move into a file name. So move testfile.txt into testfile2.txt. Now, when I list the directories, testfile is gone, testfile2 is there, and it still has the contents that we created before. So that's pretty good stuff. Likewise, you can combine those. Say I want to move testfile2 into dot dot slash test1 slash new test.txt. That kind of combines all that we've done, right? We're moving this file up and down into another directory and giving it a new name. So now if I cd into test1, I ls, new test is there, and like always, it has the contents that we were there before. Now, if we wanted to add or remove contents to that file, we can go back into nano and just edit away. More stuff here. Control O to write, enter, and Control X to exit. The up arrow to cycle through previous commands. Cat has the extra stuff that I added there. All right, now there's one more thing I want to show you. Let's go up a level into my home directory. I have test one and test two. I want to get rid of those, right? So I'm going to do a rmdir for remove directory test two, and it can go away. Show you. Test one is still here, test two is gone. Okay, so we've gotten rid of test two that's empty. Now we want to get rid of test one. Now, if I just do an rmdir test one, it's going to fail to remove that because there's a file in there. Now, if I know I don't care about what's in that directory, what I can do is an rm minus r, the name of the directory. Now it's gone. You see, both test one and test two are gone, and whatever was in that directory is gone with it. So let's review real quick. Mkdir, make a directory. Touch, create a file. MV, move a file, or rename a file, or both. RMDIR removes a directory. RM minus R removes a directory and everything in it. And Control L clears the screen. Clear also clears the screen. The up arrow cycles through your commands, and Control D will close your terminal. So that is all stuff you will use all the time. So get some practice in with those commands. Be very careful what you're deleting. Be very careful what you're editing. You can nano into some stuff and change it around and break your system. So be very, very careful with that, especially anything that requires sudo privileges. And that's the basics of how you manage files within the Linux command line. I hope that you learned something there. Let me know if you have any questions or comments. And thank you very much for joining me on Fairly Basic Tech.